أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن تبعه وولاه وسلم تسليما كثيرا. أما بعد, we continue with the commentary on العقيدة الواسطية for شيخ الإسلام ابن تيمية رحمه الله. And we stopped at the علم of Allah سبحانه وتعالى. We talked about the different opinions of deviated sects as Al-Mu'tazila in regards to the ilm of Allah Azza wa Jal. We talked also about the Mafatih al-Ghayb, the keys of the Ghayb of Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala. علم الله عز وجل, that علم of Allah is an attribute to him, علم in a way that fits him سبحانه وتعالى. معتزلة, they negated the attributes of Allah سبحانه وتعالى. Some of him said the علم is an, by himself, it's not like an attribute of Allah سبحانه وتعالى. Some they interpreted the attributes with other يعني with the opposite, يعني means he is knowledgeable means he is not ignorant. طيب, what kind of knowledge and what is that? Is a characteristic? No, it's not a characteristic, it's part of him. So this ayah here, وعنده مفاتيح الغيب لا يعلمها إلا هو, يعني nobody knows it but him. So his ilm. Well, the problem is that they're trying to get out of the issue of the ilm is acquired. So if the ilm is acquired, that means where did he acquire it from? يعني, of course, still they're stuck with the ability of the human being. They're trying to interpret everything from the narrow vision or the limited ability of the human being.
Would you say this is tashbih?
No, kind of not tashbih, but they are trying to avoid the tashbih.
But they fall into it.
But they fall into it in another way.
Another way.
Yeah, this is the easiest thing is to say that Allah Azza wa Jal ليس كمثله شيء. Attribute is the same, but meaning is different. Yes, يعني this is it's very simple. Is Allah life or dead? He's alive. Is his life like our life? Because our life means life opposite to death. Life of the tree is different from our life. Life of an animal is different from our life. But all would be considered alive. And Allah is alive. Then the ilm of Allah is like the life of Allah is different. The ilm of Allah is different. وهكذا. يعني علم, it is not opposite of جهل. It is like life of Allah is not opposite to death. يعني Allah عز وجل حي لا يموت. يعني it is a hayah that it is not ending by death. And this is very hard to perceive from someone that will die. Well, the philosophers, يعني ابن تيمية mentioned the aqidah of the philosophers in regards to the ilm of Allah. So philosophers said, God knows in general, but he does not know the specifics or the parts of that. So he knows that you are going to pass the exam. He doesn't know how we're going to do that. طبعا this again can go back to them. That means God has a defect. يعني he's not aware. يعني if somebody, يعني the professor can be aware of your degree and the specifics, and you're saying God is not aware of the specifics. So you're having a problem now with that. وهذا القدرية, القدرية that يعني they denied القدر, قالوا لا قدر والأمر أنف, يعني Allah will not figure out things until it is done. That's even worse. Yeah, it's even worse. يعني they will have no idea about what we're gonna do next until we do it. That means what is his point and what is his job then? If this is the case. Yeah, even logically speaking. Okay, if he's not aware of us praying Fajr until we pray Fajr, So what is the point now? So he's in the receiving end of things that he's not aware of, means we are in control, he's in the receiving end. So we are basically the God and he's not.
Are the Qadariya, are they also like philosophers?
Qadariya, no. Qadariya means it's not that they believe in the Qadar, that they deny the Qadar. But yani, I'm saying logically speaking, yani, if Allah does not know that I'm going to pray until I finish the prayer, and he's not going to know how I'm going to finish the prayer until I finish the prayer. So what is his job basically as a God? Yani? Like, like he's sitting in the receiving end, means does he need me to pray? If you say no, he does not need you to pray, means he doesn't care and he doesn't know. Fayani, always the argument comes back very flawed.
Yeah.
Flawed. Okay. Because they try also to avoid another issue. Then if the opposite group is called Jabriya, Abul Jahmiya. They say that Allah forces us to do everything. And he knows everything, and we are just doing that. So these guys are trying to avoid that by denying the Qadr altogether.
Mm.
And the other ones are using Qadr as an excuse altogether.
Mm.
And those ones are negating it altogether. So this is the problem. So sometimes it's good to use the argument of each one against each other. And then, you know, like, okay, let them have it, and then you know you kind of like defeat both, and there, yeah. For in every religion, this is not true. You have to have a choice somehow, but you cannot comprehend that choice in relationship to Allah's power and knowledge. That's why, for us, it's kind of a paradox. Like, how come Allah Azza wa Jalla knows everything, yet he would punish and he will do reward, since he knows everything? This is the universal knowledge. But the shar'i knowledge is that Allah said what is halal and what is haram. People have an issue with that, having issue with this qadr all the time. Why? In my opinion, yani, because again, you are putting Allah Azza wa Jalla with his jalal, with his qadr, in front of you as another party. Yani. Like, you know, why do you do that and still you do that? It's kind of like the al-abd wa sayyid concept is not there. You are abd, slave, and he's the sayyid, master. He tells you what to do and let you do it. But he knows what you're going to do. So when you come back, he'll reward you or punish you. Unless you act like a slave of Allah, you'll not get that point, the qadr. Yani, you trust that Allah is your caretaker. He knows about you better than you know about yourself. And the way Allah Azza wa Jalla handles things and look at things, you cannot comprehend that. He's looking at everything simultaneously with all its scenarios and probabilities and everything. And it's very hard to comprehend that. So you cannot, Allah does not have to be accountable to you or me or to anybody. لا يسألوا عما يفعلوا وهم يسألون. He's not asked about what he does, why he does it. Then the believer is always submitting to Allah and will never use the Qadr as an excuse over Sharia. What does it mean? Means I have Sharia rules, I cannot use the Qadr as an excuse not to follow. I said, okay, since Allah knows I'm going to go to Jannah or Hellfire, so why should I pray? Why you shouldn't pray? And why choose not to do while you can do? Same argument. Like, if you say, okay, since he knows I'm going to go to Jannah or Hellfire, why should I pray? Why you shouldn't pray? Yani, if you do not pray, he knows whether you go to Jannah. Also, if you pray, he knows whether you go to Jannah. So it's the same at the end. So basically, act as you, if you are in control of the situation. So just do from your end and leave it to Allah Azza wa Jalla. He can change whatever he wants. He can, subhanahu wa ta'ala, because he's out of the time frame. Yeah, no time frame for him, no place frame for him. So when he acts or he decides, subhanahu wa ta'ala, out of the time frame. And we are within the time frame, that's why all our mind is wired to think like that. Like, he did how he will. Correct? because we are in a time frame here. But for Allah, is everything happened, happening, will happen at the same time. So you cannot say He decided, how come He will? That does not apply to Allah Azza wa Jal. So how are you gonna talk about it? You see? So for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He's out of time. He cannot be bound by time. He cannot be bound by place. Imagine if you go out of this construct of yesterday, tomorrow, today. Everything is happening at one instant. There is very hard, it's very hard to to imagine that. Doesn't make sense, exactly. Yeah, so all the experiences and everything is like out of the time frame. So you cannot deal with Allah based on your boundaries. No, there's no boundaries for Him, subhanahu wa ta'ala. No. طيب, then the Shaykh would say, Allah Azza wa Jal says, إِنَّ اللَّهَ هُوَ الرَّزَّاقُ ذُو الْقُوَّةِ الْمَتِينَ. He says, Shaykh Salman Taymiyyah, that this ayah affirmed the characteristic of Allah, the name of Allah, Ar-Razzaq. Ar-Razzaq is the one who provides over and over and over. Raziq, yani his provider. Razzaq, yani he's doing it over and over. Mubalagha fir rizq, yani this is over and over. That He gives His servants rizq after rizq after rizq, provision after provision. And everything that comes as of benefit to His servants is called rizq. Not necessarily money only. Health is rizq, ilm is rizq, children rizq. So rizq means something you are provided. Allah Azza wa Jalla provided you. And the rizq, يعني whether it comes to a person from Allah, it's called rizq. Maybe it is not allowed to have it, but it is coming. يعني He sends your way things, but He tells you what to accept, what not to accept. Same thing for the qadr. يعني. Allah Azza wa Jal said, وَالنَّخْلَ بَاسِقَاتٍ لَهَا طَلْعٌ نَضِيدٌ رِزْقًا لِلْعِبَادِ. Surah Qaf, verse number 10, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, and the palm trees, you see how big and how blooming they are. لَهَا طَلْعٌ نَضِيدٌ, it has that the dates coming out of it and strong, you know. رِزْقًا لِلْعِبَادِ, that is rizq for everybody. Does that mean that you any dead palm tree you go and you just go access the fruit and eat it? That would be haram. But you have written to eat that. So it's a rizq coming to you, you choose to take it from halal or haram, you go buy it or you go steal it. وَفِي السَّمَاءِ رِزْقُكُمْ وَمَا تُوَعَدُونَ. In the heavens, you know, when the rain comes and everything, and Allah decided, what have you been promised and what is your rizq? So anything that you are allowed to take, that becomes halal. In the sharia, يعني, and if it is not, then it is haram. But all is called rizq. يعني, Allah Azza wa Jalla gives the rizq for humans on earth. Your rizq, my rizq, every XYZ human being rizq, it is on earth. So this is my risk, your risk, his risk, everybody's risk. Now, how that risk comes to you, it can be through halal way or haram way. How do you go get your risk? It can be through halal way and haram way. That's why, again, don't use the qadr, an excuse for sharia. You grab something from someone and eat it, and you say, that's my risk. Yeah. Allah wrote me this apple as my risk, but you stole it. You say, but it's my risk. Yeah, it is your risk, but you got it in a haram way. Abdullah ibn Mas'ud said, أقرأني رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم إني أنا الرزاق ذو القوة المتين. يعني آية was recited like that before, you know, the قراءات and abrogation of the قراءة and all that. He said, you know, that الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم made me recite or taught me how to recite, I am the one who is الرزاق المتين. بدل إن الله هو الرزاق إني أنا الرزاق. In the recitation يعني. ذو القوة يعني the one who have the قوة power ability. It's like القوي. In some أي القوي إن خير من استأجرت القوي. يعني القوي سيدنا موسى عليه السلام said he's the strong one. And one of the names of Allah is Al-Qawi. He's Al-Qawi. But why he said Dhul Quwwah instead of Al-Qawi? Al-Qawi means strong. But Dhul Quwwah, يعني the power is in his hand. But he's Qawi, he's strong. Based on what? Al-Qawi, he's Qawi, right? طبعا stronger than everybody. But the way Dhul Quwwah, يعني the power is in his hand. He can do whatever he wants with it. It's more, يعني stronger in meaning. And Allah Azza wa Jalla also the one who has the power. And all the power supplies with him subhanahu wa ta'ala. So he would not get weaker. And he will not give up subhanahu wa ta'ala. Mateen, يعني الشديد. As Abdullah ibn Abbas said. Strong, يعني الشديد. ليس كمثله شيء وهو السميع البصير. وقوله إن الله نعيم ما يعظكم به إن الله كان سميعا بصيرا سمعا بصر يعني. This first ayah سورة الشورى number 11. Second ayah سورة النساء 58. ليس كمثله شيء وهو السميع البصير. It shows us that the two characteristics or attributes of hearing and seeing they are affirmed to Allah سبحانه وتعالى. ليس كمثله شيء. يعني when they say ليس كمثله شيء, so nothing like him means he does not have attributes. Everybody has attributes means also he doesn't have attributes. So he said nobody is like him, right? And everybody has attributes. Then that means he doesn't have attributes. Those people who make تعطيل. So there, this is their argument. يعني. So Allah said ليس كمثله شيء. طب what's هو السميع البصير then? What do you want to do with it?
Yeah.
It has to mean something else. So so basically those who want to do ta'atil, they will end up doing ta'wil. And those who do ta'wil, they will end up doing tahrif. And those who do, so that's why the solution is very simple. Is to say he has, but not like. Yes. So Allah has the characteristics, but not like anybody else. But here, that's what they're trying to do. Said, ليس كمثله شيء in the being and in the attributes. No. ليس كمثله شيء the way as a being, but يعني everything is a being. But he is the one who made everything. كن فيكون. So nobody will be like him. And he's not like anybody. But he has characteristics. Ibn al-Qayyim, he said, ليس كمثله شيء. Nothing is similar to him. That it means, actually it means that no partner with him subhanahu wa ta'ala and no one with him deserving worship and revering as the mushrikeen would do. And he's not negating the characteristics of his highness subhanahu wa ta'ala, of his perfection subhanahu wa ta'ala, if of his speech subhanahu wa ta'ala, is talking to his rusul and messengers. The believers will see him yawm al-qiyamah as they see the moon and the sun and all of that. Sami' يعني the one who hears all voices and all sounds. Doesn't matter how low it is or how high they are. He knows the secret things. He knows the whispering at all times, simultaneously, instantly, all. And he hears in a way that it does not, it is not similar to his creation. Same thing for Al-Basir, the one who sees everything subhanahu wa ta'ala, aware of all the things that is to be seen. It doesn't matter how hidden it is, how fading it is. There is no barriers for him. He sees through everything subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this attribute is affirmed to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We as humans or any other creation have limitations. below certain degree you cannot hear, above certain degree you cannot hear, within a certain degree you can see, higher you can see, lower you cannot see. So it's limited at the end of the day. Animals will see sharper than you, an eagle will see sharper than you. From all this height he will see the fish in the water. So they see, a cat would see, an animal, the bat will see, will hear sounds. Animals will see at night, they have night vision. You need technology to do that. Hearing, if the sound goes in a higher pitch, that you cannot hear. And if it goes in a lower, you cannot hear. Ultrasound, this is the highest thing. And then when the sound becomes ultra, it sees. That's why you put the sound waves and it takes an image.
Yeah.
It becomes seen. And yes, very interesting, of course. So this is amazing. That's why whenever you know you focus on the signs, if you believe in Allah, then you know what characteristics of Allah mean.
Exactly.
Because you know, go beyond the human ability. Say, if this is us humans and we're limited like this, and these things exist, like you need all this microscope to see the moon and the surface of the moon and all that. Yeah, and imagine Allah Azza wa Jalla is looking at all this, the tiniest of things in all this massive universe. That shows you. Imam Abu Dawood narrated in his Sunan that the hadith of Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu, that he that Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam recited, "Inna Allah kana sami'an basira." So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam did like this. فوضع إبهامه على أذنه والتي تليها على عينه. إن الله كان سميعا بصيرا. يعني he's not saying that Allah has an ear or an ear. لا, he's telling us that what is سمع for us, what is a, يعني processing sounds, processing vision, you know, processing things. Allah Azza wa Jal does that. إِنَّ اللَّهَ كَانَ سَمِيعًا بَصِيرًا. But the Rasul صلى الله عليه وسلم, he is not assimilating Allah to this. يعني Allah sees and Allah hear. Allah Azza wa Jal sees with an eye because تجري بأعيننا. يعني Allah mentioned it. يعني الأشاعرة they said سميعا, يعني he's aware of the things, of the sounds, not hearing them, he's aware of them. بصير يعني he's aware of the seen things, but they are not, they don't want to say the word hearing, they don't want to say the word seeing.
So even because these are some of the sifat they affirm,
right,
even then they do tell me
this. They still, yes. And this is not right, because the blind person knows that the heaven is aware, but he doesn't see it. Right? So you are accusing Allah that he does not have sight. And the person who is deaf, he knows there are sounds, but he cannot hear it. Yeah. And he knows there are sounds, but he cannot hear them. And the blind knows that there are images, but he cannot see them. Then he goes to the explanation of another ayah. وقوله ولولا إذ دخلت جنتك قلت ما شاء الله لا قوة إلا بالله. وقوله ولو شاء الله ما اقتتلوا ولكن الله يفعل ما يريد. وقوله أحلت لكم بهيمة الأنعام إلا ما يتلى عليكم غير محل الصيد وأنتم حرم إن الله يحكم ما يريد. وقوله فمن يريد الله أن يهديه يشرح صدره للإسلام ومن يريد أن يضله يجعل صدره ضيقا حرجا كأنما يصعد في السماء. Now Sheikh al-Islam is going to bring the ayat that mentioning المشيئة والإرادة. المشيئة means Allah's will, إرادة يعني willing to do things. مشيئة شاء يعني he wills it to happen. والإرادة he wills it to be executed. يعني أرادها سبحانه وتعالى.
Intention and will.
not intention هم مشيئة والإرادة يعني intention to do and the will to do the will to do. ولولا إذ دخلت جنتك. So those آيات تدل على إثبات الإرادة والمشيئة. ومني آيات في القرآن شاء دور شاء ويشاء ويريد وأراد يعني الأشاعرة they said there's only one إرادة there is only one إرادة يعني الله willed everything خلاص he's not gonna have إرادة for everything يعني separate so he willed everything to be and he got over with that بس مشيئة الله عز وجل في القدر يعني في everything happening that's why we say إن شاء الله every day يعني يعني we do not say إذا كان الله شاء يعني if Allah willed it we say إن شاء الله يعني for things that but they say that it's before the creation everything Allah willed everything so it's already planned and done والمعتزلة again they just negate the إرادة يعني that's all of them they have those issues يعني طيب they also avoiding the issue of القدر see القدر يعني that if Allah will this why he does this they are avoiding that يعني ف يعني الأشاعرة said the إرادة happen That means things will happen without a will. Again, general irada. But specific irada, no. So that will become a problem. بس المعتزلة يعني they will say that Allah will things but without an action happen. يعني he make a will. So that means now the characteristic is there by itself without something. يعني how Allah make irada when there is no action يعني he wills something but it doesn't happen what does that mean so he said that he has an irada but not necessarily attached to something so what does that mean يعني somebody have a will to do something but he doesn't do it or it's not done بس أهل الحق يقولون الإرادة على نوعين Allah has two types of will مشيئة يعني إرادة إرادة كونية ترادفها المشيئة that everything Allah would will to do or to bring about and anything that Allah عز وجل يعني will bring out some will bring something about only when he wills it إنما أمره إذا أراد شيئا أن يقول له كن فيكون يعني once the irada be there then Allah will execute what happens so Allah will not say to something to happen without him intending it so the idea will come to him and you know so Allah عز وجل intended to happen then Allah says كن فيكون الحديث الله عز وجل الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم said ما شاء الله كان وما لم يشأ لم يكن يعني whatever Allah wills will happen whatever Allah doesn't will not happen طب this is the first إرادة كوني إرادة or things to happen or not happen this is we call the universal will the universal قدر of Allah يعني طيب what is the شرعي إرادة شرعي إرادة يعني what Allah wants شريعة wise that Allah says I like this and I don't like that but he created both the what he likes and what he doesn't like but that's the universal one that's with Allah you cannot account him for why you brought Iblis why you had Fir'aun Why you did you bring the poverty? Why you cannot ask Allah these questions? هذه إرادة كونية universal إرادة that for things to have like that to be balanced like this. الليل والنهار والشمس والقمر الخير والشر opposite يعني evil and good and all that. بس الإرادة الشرعية الله عز وجل does not like كفر. الله عز وجل does not like you to drink. Does not like you to commit zina. But Allah is the one who created those concepts. Yeah. And Allah Azza wa Jal does not want a person to disbelieve in Him. Where it is mentioned, يريد الله بكم اليسر ولا يريد بكم العسر. Allah wants ease for you, but He does not want hardship. But who created hardship? And you do not say that both have to be together, because this is where everybody have a problem. But each one can be connected to something. يعني the universal will of Allah Azza wa Jal, it is about what Allah likes or dislikes. It does not matter يعني what He likes and dislikes. We're not going to say that why He created this if He dislike it. إرادة الله الكونية is the general one. We only understand the part of what He likes and what He dislikes. That's the part that we need to follow. Do not follow الإرادة الكونية. Said Allah created Iblis. So why do not I do not sympathize with him? لا, you don't sympathize with him because Allah is the one who created him, told you don't sympathize with him. Make sense now? Because the people in Mecca were saying that Allah is the one who killed that animal, so why we don't eat from it? You only eat from what you slaughter with your own knife, and this is the one Allah killed it. Allah is the one who slaughtered it with His knife. See the argument here? So the answer for that is He is the one who killed that animal, and He's the one who told us not to eat. He's the one who created the pork, and He's the one who told us not to eat it. He is the one who created the haram but told us not to go do it. He's the one who created the evil, but He told us not to. He's the one who created the disease, and He told you to be healthy. So, do not mix the universal irada with the shari'i irada. Right. Sometimes the two irada comes together, meaning Allah created faith and Allah created faithfulness. So if a person believes, that's his qadr, that's Allah created the will. And Allah loves the person to believe and become faithful. So both match here. Right? So the believing of the believer, the obedience of the obedient, is both kauni and shara'i. But the disbelief of the person, they're not matching. Because Allah is the one who created the disbelief, Allah is the one who created the kufr, but He hates a person to become a kafir. So not necessarily matching. And that's where the people have a problem. Saying, you know, how come He created it but He doesn't like it? Yeah. Because He's not like you. Like, you will only do things that you like. You are not going to create a gun to kill yourself with it. Yani. You see, this is the idea here. But Subhanallah, sometimes people also do things that destroy them, but they don't care. وَلَوْلَا إِذْ دَخَلْتَ جَنَّتَكَ قُلْتَ مَا شَاءَ اللَّهُ لَا قُوَّةَ إِلَّا بِاللَّهِ. A person has to get out of his own مشيئة. يعني ما شاء الله, only what Allah wills. لا قوة إلا بالله, no power with what Allah. Means I do not have a will, I do not have a power with Allah's will and Allah's power. ولو شاء الله ما اقتتلوا, if Allah wills, they would not have fought each other or killed each other. That the people who followed messengers before, they fought each other. And they were jealous from each other, they were envying each other. All of this with the mashi'ah of Allah. بس هذه مشيئة كونية. This is the universal mashi'ah. Does Allah like this? No, He doesn't like people. Because Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم said, لا تحاسدوا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اجتنبوا كثيرا من الظن إن بعض الظن إذ ولا تجسسوا. Do not spy on each other. So those are things Allah created, but Allah doesn't like it, right? فمن يرد الله أن يهديه, whomever Allah wills to guide, he will be guided. And all guidance and the deviation is a creation of Allah. But Allah loves people to take the guidance and hates people to take the deviation path. But Allah is the one who created both. وَأَحْسِنُوا إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُحِبُّ الْمُحْسِنِينَ وَأَقْسِطُوا إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُحِبُّ الْمُقْسِطِينَ وَعَدِنْ إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُحِبُّ الْمُتَّقِينَ إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُحِبُّ التَّوَّابِينَ. Now the حب, love, يعني the characteristic of love. إن الله يحب التوابين ويحب المتطهرين. قل إن كنتم تحبون الله فاتبعوني يحببكم الله فسوف يأتي الله بقوم يحبهم ويحبونه. إن الله يحب الذين يقاتلون في سبيله صفا كأنهم بنيان مرصوص. Those are the verses بقرة البقرة 195 والحجرات number 9 توبة number 7 والبقرة 222 آل عمران 31 والمائدة 54 والصف number 4 على الترتيب يعني. This is the order that we recite this ayat for, and all this characteristic is the صفة المحبة, characteristic of المحبة. And Allah loves some people, some actions, some morals and manners. And this is a characteristic of Allah Azza wa Jal. Fits him subhanahu wa ta'ala in a way that fits him subhanahu wa ta'ala. And it is among the characteristics of optional or choice action. Action by choice. Nobody forcing you to do it. Yani. Nobody would force you to love something. اختياريه يعني. Allah loves something, he dislikes something else. Some people dislikes other people. الأشاعرة والمعتزلة they negate المحبة because they say that it will imply deficiency. يعني when you love someone you need, so there's a deficiency. يعني you lean towards something that to fill a vacuum, to fill something like that, that love and that passion to fulfill. So they said mahabba means irada. He wills to be good to someone. Yeah. Mahabbat Allah, يعني that Allah wants to honor him. That is the meaning of loving. يعني Allah loves someone means Allah's will to honor or reward. But they don't say the mahabba has like this emotion or have that feeling, yani. Because mahabba is a feeling, and if Allah feels, that means he lacks something that he fulfills by that feeling. Needs to be loving, needs to love, needs to be loved. And the same thing they say about being pleased, being angry, wrath of Allah. They say all of this is either reward or punishment. His will to reward or punishment.
That's
the Asha'ira. The Mu'tazila are different. Mu'tazila, they said no irada at all, and no mahabba at all. Yani they say the reward itself is the mahabba. The Asha'ira said Allah's will to reward is the mahabba. Yani Allah's willingness to reward, this is the mahabba of Allah. Mu'tazila said the reward itself is the mahabba. Yani Allah's mahabba is like Jannah. Allah's mahabba is that he gave you something.
That's quite materialistic.
Very materialistic, yes. And according to Mu'tazila, they said it is wajib on Allah to reward the obedient, and it is wajib on Allah to punish the disobedient. But that's why they said the mahabba is like why he would love if it is a must on him actually to reward. Right?
Yeah.
For that's, see, when you go to their madhab, you find it's nonsense.
Yeah.
Like, basically, if you just use your logic, you find it's kind of like, what? It contradicts itself. And they assume something or they make a statement, and then based on it, you'll find 5-6 deficiencies and flaws. Yeah. And they start filling it. Mm. And by filling it, they make another flaw.
Yeah, exactly.
And that's why people get lost in the madhab. But the madhab actually is so defective. It's full of holes everywhere. Mm-hmm. Mm. We affirm the characteristic of muhabbat to Allah, like we affirm the characteristics of anger, of displeasure. Allah comes down, Allah walks to someone in a way fits him subhanahu wa ta'ala. فيعني, as we say Allah has the will, Allah has the will to love someone, Allah loves someone, and Allah has the will to reward someone, and Allah rewards someone. كل هذه صفات لله عز وجل يعني. كل this are actions of Allah that we cannot deny any part of it. طيب الشيخ يعني the one who explains commentary says يعني how what they would do with the hadith of Allah. حديث رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم إن الله إذا أحب عبدا نادى جبريل إني أحب فلان فأحبه. يعني if Allah loves someone he calls Jibril and he said I love this person. How do you interpret that I love this person? Why Allah did not say, I will to love this person.
Right.
I'm willing to love, or I want a reward.
Yeah.
He said, I love him, you love him too. Mm-hmm. So the love of Allah is different from the love of Jibreel. Right? And Jibreel says to other angels, Allah loves and I love you love. Okay? إِنَّ رَبَّكُمْ يُحِبُّ فُلَانًا فَأَحِبُّوهُ So أَهْلُ السَّمَاءِ يُحِبُّونَهُ وَيُوضَعُ لَهُ الْقَبُولُ فِي الْأَرْضِ The acceptance will be put for him on earth. And if he hates or dislikes someone, he will say, Jibreel, I hate that person, you hate him. Same thing, يعني. And this hadith in Bukhari and Muslim. وَأَحْسِنُوا Allah Azza Jal said, make ihsan in everything. والإمام مسلم he said الله عز وجل يعني الإمام مسلم narrated in الصحيح حديث شداد بن أوس that رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم said إن الله كتب الإحسان على كل شيء الله عز وجل ordained إحسان on everything if you kill you kill with إحسان and if you slaughter you slaughter with إحسان يعني even when they kill someone execute someone an execution with the sword you have to do it fast unless they did you know other things there are different ways but you do it fast with the sharp sword and you do not the punishment here it is not to torture
mm-hmm. exactly.
the punishment actually is to make a statement right punishment to torture is other things like zina for example because the person enjoyed so the pleasure you have to have some torture and the person also hurt other people so the killing will be with torture
mm-hmm.
But if we slaughter an animal, you slaughter it fast, with ihsan.
Yeah.
Because you're going to kill it anyways.
Mm-hmm.
So shoot it or do this or that. لا. We say with ihsan. So you have to make them go down calmly. You sharpen the knife. All of those kind of things. إِنَّ اللَّهُ يُحِبُّ الْمُحْسِنِينَ It is kind of the cause. Why you have to have ihsan? Because Allah loves the Muhsineen. So if we wanted to Allah to love you, so be among the Muhsineen. وَأَيْضًا أَقْسِطُوا يعني be just because Allah loves those who are just. So fix, heal the rift between the Muslims and all of that. So be just. then he explains, فَمَسْتَقَامُوا لَكُمْ فَاسْتَقِيمُوا لَهُمْ يعني في سورة التوبة that always be good with the people يعني that who have treaties with you or who want to have treaties with you as long as the treaty is there everybody keeping their end of the bargain you keep your end of the bargain إن الله يحب المتقين يعني it is taqwa to be just and to keep your end of the bargain if the person in front of you is following the deal you follow the deal Why? Because this is taqwa and Allah loves the muttaqeen. So here Allah is saying, Allah loves the muhsineen, so do this ihsan. Allah loves the muttaqeen, so do this taqwa.
Mm-hmm.
Allah loves the tawabeen, those who want to do tawbah.
Mm-hmm.
Allah loves the mutatahireen, so do tahara.
Mm-hmm.
That's why I always say, if you want to do an action that you are 100% sure that Allah loves you while you are doing it, do one of those actions. When you're making wudu or taking ghusl or tahara, Allah loves you because you are doing that, so have intention. When you do ihsan somewhere, Allah loves you at that time. When you do the tawbah, Allah loves you at that time. Inna Allah yuhibbu at-tawabin. Those who go tawbah, not at-ta'ibin, tawabin. يعني they always do the tawbah and repent and go back to Allah Azza wa Jal. So Allah loves them that they go back to Allah. So those are al-mutatahirin, those who do tahara. All the time as well, and that they make sure it is done properly.
Mm-hmm.
Not only the minimum, yeah. قل إن كنتم تحبون الله فاتبعوني يحببكم الله. Some people said that we love Allah عز وجل, so Allah revealed this ayah as mihna. This is the ayah of test, of trial. It's called the ayah of test or trial. Ayat al-mihna. So if you love Allah then you have to follow Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم. It's not just a talk so those who follow Rasulullah those who hold fast those who follow it sincerely are the ones who deserve the love of Allah عز وجل inshallah we stop here and next time we talk about other characteristics like الغفور والودود والرحمن والرحيم والرحمة والعلم يعني الغفران والرحمة. So إن شاء الله we stop here إن شاء الله. صلى الله وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد والحمد لله رب العالمين. السلام عليكم.